everyone for attending tonight. I'd just like to say what a magnificent artist that Robyn is, and not just a beautiful artist, but an absolutely magnificent person. I hope you all enjoyed tonight. I'd just like to introduce Linda Burney, who's the member for Canterbury. May I introduce Linda Burney, and might I say she's wearing a beautiful dress designed by Robyn Caughlan. Linda Burney.
Thank you to the dancers and the didge players. Absolutely beautiful. And thank you to Gaza for your welcome and your amazing space. And thank you to Grant for the welcome tonight. I am really quite moved to be invited by Robyn to be part of this evening. And I want to make it a very personal journey tonight and talk about how Robyn and I first met. I promise you it won't go on for ages. I'm wearing stilettos, and anyone wearing stilettos doesn't talk for too long. That's the truth. The name of this exhibition from canvas to catwalk really does describe the journey, everyone. I was in Bathurst all day today, and I left at 6 o'clock this morning and got back about 6 o'clock this evening. And I was determined to rush home and put on this incredible skirt. And I know I'm not tall and skinny, but it is absolutely beautiful. And this skirt was made by Robyn Caughlan about 10 years ago. And Robyn, I've treasured it and I've worn it many times and thought of you. It's hand painted, and I really wanted to wear it as a special tribute to you this evening. I met Robyn, I can say how long ago it is, it's 10 years ago. And there's actually an amazing story that you might not know that I want to share with people this evening. Robyn made, I don't own many evening gowns, and Robyn made two evening gowns for me. And the one that I still have is timeless. It's black, it's a halter neck, and it holds up your boobs. And that's all pretty good. But the wonderful thing about that is that I met the love of my life 10 years ago, and that ball gown played a significant part in that story. Unfortunately, yes, on Sunday we commemorated 1 year of the love of my life's death, and I touched that ball gown on Sunday and remembered you and remembered the amazing role that it had in that story. I also wanted to say that one of the things that we do as a country very badly is pull down people, or if anyone tells their story or celebrates their story, then somehow it's seen as big noting. But I think that one of the things that we as a nation should do more of is actually celebrate the narrative of the individual, because the narrative of a whole nation is made up by our personal stories. When I think of Australia, everyone, I think of it as an amazing mosaic of tiles, millions of tiles, some of them shiny, some of them green, some of them blue, some of them black, some of them large, some of them small. Every single one of those tiles represents part of our national narrative. And the tile of Robyn Caughlan is beautiful, it's deep, it's shiny, and it's creative. And it's a tile that tells the story of a woman who comes from the oldest living culture on our planet. It tells the story of a woman that has struggled. It tells the story of a woman that makes beautiful things. And that is how I think of Robyn. And I'm sure that those of you that know her would share that too. I am not an artist, but I have a good eye. And I know that art reflects who we are as a nation. I know that art inspires. I know that art is about pain and beauty and celebration. But what would a society would be? What would a society be if there wasn't our artists? What would a society be if there wasn't our storytellers? And artists are storytellers. And it's the way in which we interpret and the way in which, Robyn, you give those stories, that is just so multifaceted and just so important. I want to finish up before saying that I'm so honoured to be asked to be the special guest this evening. I want to say that Australia... I so often hear people in high positions say that Australia is a young country, and it annoys the hell out of me, because Australia is an ancient country with a shared heritage and a shared history. And we need to come to the point where we don't ghettoise Aboriginal artists by saying they're an Aboriginal artist and they're somehow over here. What we need to come to say is this, that people like Robyn Caughlan is an Australian artist and she's an Aboriginal woman. Thank you all very much.